they win their final two games, and they will be in the postseason for a 17th straight year.
There's no easy games in this league. You never count out the superheroes. When this team's been good this year, they've been really good. And when they have not been good, they've been really bad.
Crosby,
and some really good looks. Peter Mrazek on point tonight with the Blackhawks to strike first.
They're not going to back off.
Oh,
not many buddies in Pittsburgh right now for him.
Chicago, a 3-1 lead.
I cannot believe it. It's a shocker, really. The ball was in their court to win out, take care of business. A shocker here tonight.
The madness continues. Hello and welcome to On the Fly. I'm Jamie Hirsch. The Penguins squandered a golden opportunity to jump back into the playoff picture by losing to the Blackhawks in regulation at home on Tuesday night. That set up the ideal situation for the Islanders on Wednesday. Get 1 point, and they're in the playoffs. This could mark the end of an historic 16-year playoff run for the Penguins, while also marking the return of the Isles after missing out last season. And an Isles win would put them in the first wildcard spot for the time being, avoiding the mighty Bruins in the first round. Got all that? Let's head to the island.
Here is Palmieri. Quick pass to Nelson, has Engvall. Nelson shoots, scores! Islanders get the first goal, and who else? Brock Nelson.
Unbelievable play there by Brock Nelson. Shows great patience coming across the blue line, and he's got such a lethal weapon. That wrist shot just beats the goaltender.
You count on your best players at this time of the year in games like this, and Brock Nelson answers for the Islanders.
Yeah, we used to say in the 80s, scores, score, hitters, hit.
Scores for the 35th time this year. Pezzetta tips it in right to Bolden. Ooh. Turned it over. Pezzetta walks in, shoots, save. Sorokin, the rebound, hit the post. It was Teasdale in his NHL debut with a glorious chance. And it hit iron, stayed out.
Ovechkin kept it in. Dobson turned it over. Evans in the slot, fired it across, they score. Rob Pitlick from a sharp angle fires a one-timer in, and the Canadians have tied it at one.
I mentioned earlier that the Islanders are uncharacteristically giving up a lot of space on the ice.
Leaves it below the goal line. Ripped around, Pageau waiting for it. Mayfield backing him up, throw to the front, off the post, it's in! Hudson Fashing found the loose puck behind Montembeau. A minute and 19 seconds after the game was tied, Hudson Fashing gives the Islanders back the lead.
Just a lot of work by Zach Parise. The Islanders able to keep it in, and Fashing, as he does so well, goes to the net. Parise was there on the original deflection.
Noah Thompson fired it high and wide. Adam Pellett throws it to the net. Stop, Montembeau, rebound, right in the crease. Montembeau scrambles back and comes up with a glorious save to keep the puck out.
This is more like an Islander team where they get on you in your end. They put a lot of pucks to the net. They win puck battles. And Montreal bends, but they don't break. And they get a wonderful save by Montembeau.
Coming around for Dobson. Islanders turning the heat up here. Dobson, wrist shot, tip, score! Second tonight for Brock Nelson. Islanders by two.
A huge goal for the Islanders. What a great play by Dobson. Moving his feet, going from left to right, head up all the way as the Islanders win the battle along the board. Dobson will finally get something done.
Montreal number 11, 2 minutes for kneeing, 2 minutes for roughing.
Poked away by Nick Suzuki, he'll race after it. Holder scores, Nick Suzuki reaches in with a stick, he won the race. As Sorokin thought about coming out of the net to play it, and he stopped and retreated, and that allowed the captain to knock it in, a shorthanded goal.
Your power play is not helping you, that's one thing, but man, don't let it hurt you.
To the power play go the New York Islanders. Third power play tonight for the Islanders, they're 0 for 2 with a shorthanded goal allowed. Dobson, clock hits 4 minutes. Score!
Lee, what a great deflection.
28th goal of the season, none bigger than that one from the captain who hadn't scored in 9 games. They needed all 82 to get there, but the Islanders are headed to the Stanley Cup playoffs. The Islanders, the final of the 16 teams to clinch a spot in the Stanley Cup playoffs.
The Islanders beat the Canadiens 4-2 on Wednesday to claim that last open playoff spot. Brock Nelson nets 2 in this contest and now has 6 points in his last 4 games. Plus, Noah Dobson picks up 2 helpers to extend his point streak to 4 straight. Now here's Nelson on this playoff clinching win.
This one feels good. We worked pretty hard to get to this point, gave ourselves a chance, and fans knew it was at stake and gave us some energy. That was a great atmosphere. Looking forward to more in the playoffs. A perfect time. I just said that to Lindsay. We kind of had a mix and match of units, but unbelievable tip. Great shot by Sebi and a huge goal. After that, that was it. I think that's it. I think we've been through a lot as a group over the years, and we've been here for a lot of years. So the fans, the guys, we believe in one another, and we want to get it done.
And just like that, the playoff field is set for the Eastern Conference. The Islanders punched their tickets in the postseason for the fourth time in the last 5 years and are currently sitting in the first wild card position. The Leafs and Lightning is the only confirmed matchup, as seeding is yet to be determined for all other teams. With the Isles' win, the Pittsburgh Penguins are officially eliminated from the playoffs. The longest active playoff streak in North American sports has come to an end at 16 straight seasons. This will be the first postseason where neither Sidney Crosby nor Alex Ovechkin will be competing for the Stanley Cup since all the way back in 2006. Coming up, Dallas had a chance to jump back into the Central Division lead on Tuesday. We'll have highlights from the Stars' penultimate game after the break.
To show you everything that went down.
Let's talk about tonight's matchup.
This is what it's all about.
He's a threat at any given moment.
Score! Don't blink, because we've got a ton of highlights for you.
What a hockey game!
NHL is firing on all cylinders.
Score! What a night!
Welcome back to On the Fly. It was a big game for the Stars, taking on the Blues in St. Louis.
Big game for the Stars. They can still finish in first place in the Central Division. Stars and Blues begin a home-and-home tonight. Suter joins the rush. Suter, little backhand shovel towards the net. And then they score! A couple of Stars in the vicinity. Wyatt Johnston, the rookie, as well. And Johnston has his 22nd of the season.
He's going to go and try and grab it right there. And then before he's able to, Johnston gets it and banks in and off of him.
Outstanding job by Johnston. He's got a great set of hands.
St. Louis Blues 0 for their last 16 with the man advantage. Ball slides it across. Thomas scores! On the power play, the Blues tie the game at 1.
Really pretty passing play by the Blues.
Verana outside the dots, realizes the puck is moving from one side of the ice to the other.
That breaks the 0 for 16 stretch on the power play for the Blues. Ben's pass picked off by Kasperi-Kapanen, moves in, just behind Wedgewood, and now he covers.
I don't even know if it got there. I think Hakapa saved this opportunity.
I think you're right.
Yeah, he did. He shot it back into his goaltender. That puck's going in, there's no doubt.
Penalty coming up against the Blues. Extra skater on for Dallas. And the extra skater scores! Pavelski off the bench, fires it past Hofer. 2-1 Stars.
Here comes Pavelski, right on a tee.
And Hofer can't find it.
Time winding down, here the play. What a goal! Thomas scores!
It's a pretty silky hands and mitts here.
Yeah, he makes it look easy to open. And then just roofs it.
And Thomas goes backhand, forehand, shovel.
Sammy Blais into the box for 4 minutes.
Miller is bleeding.
Amy Benn, Hintz setting up in front. Hintz with a shot. He scores! Roope Hintz set up by Benn. It's a power play goal. The Stars now lead 3-2. Power play continues. 37th goal for Hintz. Minute 15 remaining on the penalty to Blais. Johnston shoots and scores. His second of the game, set up by Dadonov. So two power play goals during the double minor. The Stars now lead 4-2.
Sagan down, and then Johnston one times it off the post and in.
Fourth consecutive penalty called on the Blues here in the second period. Here's Robertson. Haskinen. Wide shoots. Puck comes in front. They score. Sagan makes it 5-2 Dallas. It's their third power play goal in the second period on three consecutive power play shots in his 900th National Hockey League game. Shen fires off the crossbar.
What a shot by Shen. When he released that puck, he expected to score.
Unfortunately not, bar in.
Dallas Stars are going to win their fifth consecutive game and pull into first place in the Central Division. 5-2, Stars win it.
The Stars get their fifth consecutive win as they top the Blues 5-2 on Wednesday. Wyatt Johnson nets two goals and records his first career multi-goal game. Plus, Jason Robertson picks up 3 points, bringing him to 109 on the season, which is the second highest point total by a Stars skater in a single season in franchise history. And Miro Heiskanen made history on Wednesday. He picked up 2 assists in Dallas's win and now is the defenseman with the most points in a single season in Dallas Stars history, surpassing Sergei Zubov, who set the record back in the 05-06 season. Some off-ice news in the Central on Wednesday. Ryan Hartman of the Wild has been suspended 1 game for interference on Nikolaj Ehlers during Tuesday's game against the Jets. Hartman was assessed a minor penalty on the play. He'll have to sit out Minnesota's final game Thursday in Nashville. So the Central Division remains up for grabs, and the last game of the season may determine who takes home the title. Colorado and Dallas are separated by 1 point for the top spot and are both in action on Thursday. The Avs take on the Jets, while the Stars face off against St. Louis again. Minnesota still remains in the mix as well. When we come back, we'll look ahead to a couple of division races that have come down to game 82. 15 games on Thursday, and we'll look at the ones that matter most after this. Welcome back to On the Fly. Let's get out to Calgary for a couple of NHL debuts.
Goaltender Dustin Wolf and forward Matthew Coronato. Fantastic moment here before the game. The parents in-house to take a look and take this all in. Very special and a moment that will not ever be forgotten by those individuals.
Noah Gregor getting around Stone. Save. Wolf rebound. Score. It came right back to Noah Gregor, and he buries it to give San Jose the lead.
Yeah, good speed going down that left side, and that shot, I mean, just carried perfectly off the pad.
Sharks break up, power play comes to an end, one shot of the man advantage. Dumpin hit the referee. That hurt Chris Rooney, took it off the arm. Rooney's hunched over out at center ice after taking that puck, maybe off the hand, Kelly.
Ooh, I think so.
Off the forearm.
Yeah. Does not look to be in shape, continue to carry on.
Huberto stays on it.
All right, let's go.
Gets the puck to back. The Bonjabani puts it over. Jamal scores. On his career year continues. Number 12 for number 16. And we're all tied up at one.
And this is what Zadorov does often, right? He leaves his point position in the offensive zone.
Chris Rooney. Oh, good. Shaking off whatever damage was done by that shot off the arm. Stone. Coronato trying to cut off the boards. Gets the puck to the slot. Here's Coronato. Stopped by Kakkonen. Coronato, another good look.
Is he ever? Wow.
Oh, well, he bobbled the puck. Never got a clean shot away. Still loose. Gregor cut it off. Fired to the traffic. Buys it off. Hit the pile. Where is it? Just a massive humanity at the top of the goal crease, and somehow Zadorov's shot stayed out. Now the boards to Uyghur. Zadorov shoots. Scores! Nikita Zadorov gets his second of the game, and the Flames are up 2-1.
Kadri from behind the net, and there's Coronato. I don't think he deflects it, but he's awfully close.
Carlson. A timer tipped on goal.
Well, that's his best save of the night.
Carlson popped it up. Here's it all for the hat-trick. Yes, Nikita Zadorov into the empty net from 150 feet. It's his first career hat-trick. And makes it 4-3-1. Calgary. And Dustin Wolf gets a win with a 23-save performance in his first ever National Hockey League game.
The Flames finish off their season with a win, defeating the Sharks 3-1 on Wednesday. Mikhail Backlund picks up an assist, giving him 4 points in his last 5 games. Plus, Dustin Wolf makes 23 saves on 24 shots faced and becomes the fourth youngest goalie in franchise history to win his first NHL start. It was an enterprise hat trick for Nikita Zadorov. He records his first career hattie in Calgary's win on Wednesday. Zadorov is the first player for the Flames to collect a hat trick since Matthew Tkachuk did a year ago to the day. Talk about a coincidence.
He's been arrived in both 7, wanted to end.
Oh, you love to see it.
Yes! Wins it for the Devils.
The celebration begins at the rock.
The home
hopes are high for the Devils. That season opener in Philadelphia did not go as planned.
Detroit comes to the Rock and spoils the Devils' home opener.
I'm just sick and tired of being on a bad team.
I don't think anybody saw this coming. How has it happened?
This team thinks the game as fast as they move.
They just won't quit. Make it 11 in a row, baby.
This team is too good top to bottom. Jack Hughes, Nico, he's treating yes for Brett. These guys are old veterans now.
And the win streak moves to 12, number two all time in franchise history.
I think just organically they've improved, but they made some really nice additions. John Marino,
Andre Palat,
Eric Collins. They are clicking on all cylinders.
And for just the second time in franchise history, the Devils have won 13 in a row.
Jack Hughes is a slick speed timing player.
Jesper Bratt is an outstanding offensive player in his own right.
Jesper Bratt scores! And there's a franchise record season opening 11-game point streak for Bratt.
Biggest pickup in the offseason for any team, Vitek Vanacek.
Vitek Vanacek has come to play tonight.
Really proud of the Vitek.
Vitek Vanacek, third shutout of the season.
No doubt about it, Vitek Vanacek has been the biggest reason why the Devils are suddenly a legit playoff team.
After a dominating start to the season, the Devils took a tumble in December, six losses in a row.
So they're going to learn from that losing streak, like you learn from winning, and it's going to make them better.
The season continues.
The New Jersey Devils come up with their 25th win on the road.
Devils join that arms race in the East with a trade for Timo Meier.
Give me fuel, give me fire, give me Timo Black Meier.
Timo Meier for the win. He got it! And the Devils take 2 points in Washington.
Hallelujah. It's been a long time since the Devils are as good as they are now.
7-0. The Devils roll.
It started in September, and they did it.
Yeah, it's been an incredible season for the Devils, setting a new franchise mark for wins in a season. Taking a look at the Metro standings, you'll see Jersey sits just 1 point back of Carolina for first place in the division. So let's take a look back at the Hurricane season.
Score! Knocked on the door, then kicked it in. Game over! The Canes needed some lightning, and there's a strike.
This is a cup favorite for a lot of people.
Starting to set in on that Carolina bench. A disappointing end for Carolina this year.
You know, we just gotta obviously come back next year and be better.
I mean, they lost some important pieces.
This could be the year they take that next step. A couple of new pieces.
I think this team got better.
Here come the Hats! Andre Svechnikov, two games against the Oilers, six goals.
Marty, the one-man Matius's hot start continues.
Put it in the books. The first career shutout for Pyotr Kochetkov.
Freddie Anderson hurt in practice, apparently.
And the Bruins will get the extra point.
Well, they're in a little bit of a funk right now. There's no question about it.
You talk about defining moments all the time. This could be one of those today for the Carolina Hurricanes.
And he scores! Oh, they'll hear that all the way in the Bronx.
What a gritty win for the Canes. They needed one.
It's been a good week for Antti Raanta. His second shutout this season. And the Hurricanes extend their win streak. It's 11 in a row. The franchise record. And what a way to start 2023. Patrick Sebastian Aho. Aho, game over.
His sixth straight game with a goal. The Carolina Hurricanes hit the all-star break with seven straight wins.
Welcome everyone to the 47th National Hockey League outdoor regular season game.
Carolina on the board, a beautiful goal for Teravainen.
They win the first outdoor game in franchise history.
Carolina Hurricanes are acquiring Shane Gostisbehere from Arizona.
The ghost haunts his old team.
It's another perfectly played shot.
You know, you don't get a lot of these opportunities, so, you know, I'm just trying to make the best of it.
Andrei Svechnikov will undergo knee surgery, and he'll miss the remainder of the season and the playoffs.
So much pressure on Aho now with the injuries to Svechnikov. They need him to score goals. It's a hat-trick overtime winning goal for Sebastian Aho.
Carolina is heading back to the playoffs again.
We're going to get another chance to win the whole thing.
So the race to win the Metro comes down to this. The Devils trail the Hurricanes by just 1 point for that top spot, and both teams are in action on Thursday. New Jersey takes on Washington, while Carolina faces Florida to determine who will take home the title. And the Pacific is yet to be decided, too. The Oilers are in the hunt for the division title, but are 2 points behind the leading Golden Knights. Edmonton takes on the Sharks, while Vegas will be playing Seattle on Thursday, which will further determine seeding in the Pacific. The Kraken trail the Kings by just 2 points and could leapfrog LA if the Kings fall to the Ducks in regulation. Plenty to keep an eye on for Thursday. That brings us now to your top shelf plays from Wednesday.
As Engvall, Nelson shoots, scores! And who else? Brock Nelson.
Pitch pass, Robertson, jump by Haskinen, deflects off the pipe.
Lightning fast hands, doesn't he?
Zadora shoots, scores! Nikita Zadora gets his second of the game. Clock winding down, here the bird, what a ball from Thomas, scores!
The pretty silky hands and mitts here, Jones here by Thomas.
He'll race after it, Holder scores! It's Suzuki! Really crafty Suzuki, gets down on one knee and stabs this thing, top shelf.
Clock hits 4 minutes. Score! The Islanders have a two-goal lead.
And Anders Lee, what a great deflection.
They needed all 82 to get there, but the Islanders are headed to the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Welcome back. The Women's World Championship quarterfinals get underway on Thursday. We'll have Team USA's game against Germany right here on NHL Network at 1:30 Eastern. You can also catch Canada against Sweden at 5. Now it's time for your three stars from Wednesday. Our third star goes to Nikita Zadorov, who recorded his first career hat trick in the Flames win over the Sharks. It's also Zadorov's first multi-goal performance of the season. Our second star goes to Wyatt Johnston, who scored 2 goals in the Stars win over the Blues. This was the first multi-goal performance of Johnston's young career. And our first star of the night goes to Brock Nelson, who scored twice in the Islanders' 4-2 win over the Canadiens. It was Nelson's 8th multi-goal game of the season, which is tied for the team lead. Thanks for joining us here on the Fly. I'm Jamie Hirsch. We'll see you right back here for an epic 15-game slate of games on Thursday night.
The stage is set for the biggest game this new arena has ever seen. Who else? Brock Nelson.
Unbelievable play.
Makes it look easy, doesn't he?
Huge goal for the Islanders.
Now the Stars are going to win their 5th consecutive game, going into first place in the Central Division.
Nick Suzuki reaches in with a stick. He won the race.
That was a terrific save again by Kotkaniemi.
They need an